Welcome to Toronto Public Library's Mini Makers at Home. Today, we are going to be exploring an activity called Shapes and Strength, which explores building structures in different shapes to see if it can hold the weight of various objects. We will be testing the strength of our structure through two activities, where we will be making paper columns and paper blocks. Today, we are going to be engineers and use STEM concepts. It's never too early to start having fun with science, technology, engineering, and math. Parents and caregivers, you are your child's first and best teacher, and the Toronto Public Library is here to support you. Let's get started on the activity. Have you ever wondered why skyscrapers don't fall over? Why some buildings are made of wood while others are made of steel or glass? Have you ever looked at the CN Tower in Toronto? I wondered how its unique shape and design stands so tall? Well, architects and engineers plan and design different types of buildings or structures that we see around us. They have to consider many factors when designing and building, such as the way the structure will be used, weather, and even the type of soil it will be built on. They have to make sure that the building or structure can withstand forces, such as strong winds. It is also very important that the shape of the structure is designed properly, because this will affect how strong the structure will be. Today, you'll be architects and engineers making and testing the strength of different shapes using paper. You are also going to build a structure using paper columns and blocks that can support the weight of different objects found around your home. Before we start our activity, we need to gather some material found at home. The materials that you will need are construction paper, plain white paper, or any colored paper for your paper columns and blocks, tape, a pencil, scissors, and different objects that you have around your home that are different sizes and weight to test the strength of your columns and building blocks. I found some books, a toy, paper clips, and cotton balls. But you can use whichever items you can find at home. You will also need a piece of paper to record your test results. Let's begin with our first activity, making paper columns. The three different shapes that we will be making for each paper column are a square, a triangle, and a circle. To make your paper columns, you will need colored paper or plain white paper for each different shaped column and some tape. You will need 4 pieces of paper for the square columns, 4 pieces of paper for the triangle columns, and 4 pieces of paper for the circle columns. We will begin with making the square paper columns. Take your piece of paper and follow my folding instructions. Place your piece of paper like this. Fold the paper into quarters. Make sure all edges are creased. Unfold and take your tape and secure the edges of your column. Repeat this until you have a total of 4 square columns. Column is a triangle. Take your piece of paper and fold it into thirds. tape and secure the edges. Repeat this until you have a total of 4 triangle columns. The last shape column you will be making is a circle or cylinder. Take your piece of paper and roll it into a cylinder or tube. Secure the edges with tape. Repeat this until you have a total of 4 circle columns. Great job on folding each of the different shaped paper columns. We will now work on our second activity, which will be making paper blocks. Like our columns, we will be using the same 3 shapes and folding much shorter paper blocks. For the paper blocks, you will need 4 pieces of paper cut in half for the square paper blocks, 4 pieces of half paper for the triangle paper blocks, 4 pieces of half paper for the circle paper blocks, tape, and scissors. When using scissors, safety first and have an adult caregiver supervise or help you. We will begin with making the square paper blocks. Taking your piece of paper, cut it in half. Like the square paper columns, fold the half piece of paper into quarters and secure ends with tape. Repeat this until you have a total of 4 square paper blocks. The next set of paper blocks are triangles. Take your piece of paper, cut it in half, and fold it into thirds and secure the ends with tape. Repeat this until you have a total of 4 triangle paper blocks. The last shape of paper blocks is a circle. Take your piece of paper, cut it in half, and roll it into a cylinder or tube, and secure it with tape. Repeat until you have a total of 4 circle paper blocks. Perfect! Once you have finished making your different shaped paper columns and paper blocks, it is time to test them out. To test the strength of the paper columns and blocks, you will need to gather different objects from around your home. I found some books, toys, paper clips, and cotton balls, but you can use any type of objects to test with. You will need construction paper as paper planks to add as layers when building your structure, as well as a piece of paper and pencil to record your test results. Find a good space on the floor or table to test your structure. On your piece of paper, make a chart. On your chart, you can write the shape of the columns and blocks, the different objects you found around your home, and a yes or no column for recording to see if your structure was able to hold or fall down from the strength of the objects. columns and paper blocks hold up strong after testing them out? Today, all of you were scientists and recorded the results of your tests and experiments. Did you notice which shape was the strongest or weakest? How many objects did it support? Did the height of your structure make any difference? Looking at paper, it seems like a weak material. However, it can be folded into a strong shape and can be used to create buildings that support the weight of something heavier than itself. If you notice a square shape, when there's too much weight pushing down on it, it causes the top of the column to bend and break. This is because the weight gets moved to the column's edges and corners, which can't support the load. A triangle column can hold a bit more weight and not bend. With too much weight, the walls fold in, and the triangle column can fall. A circle or cylinder column is very strong because their walls don't have any edges. The force of an object stays evenly, making it able to hold a lot of heavy objects. As engineers today, you learn that many different shapes affect how a structure will be able to support more weight from different objects found at home. Explore with some other objects to see how tall you can build your structure, to see if it can hold that much weight. I hope you enjoyed today's Mini Makers at Home program. Check back soon for more Toronto Public Library Mini Makers at Home programs. Bye!